In this lesson, I will show you how to use Cisco Packet Tracer for our configurations. For our configurations for CCNA and CCNP, we will use Cisco Packet Tracer too much. So here, we will create topologies with switches, with routers or other devices. So in this lesson, I will show how to add and how to configure these devices on Cisco Packet Tracer. Here are the screen. This is our screen, and we will create our topologies here. For example, below we can take a router here, another router, and another router. I'll take the general one here. You can also select the other models of Cisco. There are too much router models here. We can connect these devices, these routers, with this part. So router to router connection, I will select crossover cable, but you can also use this automatic cabling, but I will use this one. So I'll select the interface that I will connect. Yes. This is a simple topology for us. So let's go to the router part here. On the router, you can see that there are some interfaces, some physical interfaces here, and we can change these interfaces on this screen. So I'll power off, and then I can add these interfaces one by one, or we can remove them. This is up to you. These are too much details. So in our configurations, we do not use too much these things for also CCNA. And it is good to know here. And this is the config part. Let's open our, start our router. This is the config parts, and this is a little screen-based part, but we will use the CLI-based part here for our configurations. Firstly, on a router, let's see how to do a configuration on Packet Tracer. I'll use enable command and then configure terminal. Configure terminal to go to the configuration mode. And then here, we can do any configuration on Packet Tracer. There are some command limitations on Packet Tracer, but for CCNA, especially for CCNP, it is enough. Let's change something here. Yes. I changed the name of the router, and then I use write command to save our configuration. We can check the configuration with show running config. All the configurations are under here, host name and the other configurations. We can also check the interfaces with show IP interface brief. Yes, sometimes I wrote very badly. Yes, here are our interfaces. Let's change the IP address of an interface also. Interface fast Ethernet 0.0. IP address. No shutdown. By default, all the router ports are shut down, so I change it and I open it. Again, I'll do the similar configuration on this router. Enable configure terminal. Interface fast Ethernet 0.0 and IP address. Yes, when I say no shutdown, it will be up. These links will be green. Yes, as you can see, it is true. Show IP interface brief and our interfaces are up. Yes, we have configured a basic interface configuration on the router. And this is how we do the configurations on routers. So here we can also use switches. So let's use a switch here. For example, let's use this one, this layer 2 switch, and I'll also use this layer 3 switch here. And I'll connect them with, again, crossover cable. And then I'll connect some PCs, some host devices to these devices. So it's PC, a laptop, a server, or any other things here we can add. And then I will use a connection. I can use this strength through cable or this automatic cabling. It is better to use automatic cabling here. And yes, this is our basic network. Let's use some colorful things to see a better topology. For example, I can use this one circle, and I will use a colorful part. Yes, this and this. Yes. We can also change the IP address of the devices here or any other configurations in the PC. This is like a normal PC. You can power on off, you can add interfaces, you can add different configs. But generally, we will use this desktop part, and in almost all configurations, we will do IP configurations. For example, here, let's do this one. And again, I'll configure also this one. They're in the same network, so I use the same IP address block here. So let's ping from here to here. We will also use this desktop part, this command prompt, to ping for ping. So here I will use ping. Yes, we are pinged from this device to this device. We can also do this control with these parts. I will select this one and then this one. As you can see here, it is successful. But when I do this for this one, it will be not successful because I have not configured any IP address here. Let me check. Yes, it is not functional. Yes, this is our how we do switch configurations on Cisco Packet Tracer. As you can see, there are other devices here. There are wireless devices. And let's use also a wireless example here. I'll use this one and this one again. We can create two different home networks. So let's here write our home network as home network. And then let's change this SSID with IP Cisco. We have two wireless access points, and we will connect some wireless devices to this device. So here I can take a tablet or a smartphone or anything we can add here. We can also add some IoT devices here. For example, carbon dioxide detector. Interesting. A ceiling fan. A door. A garage door. Anything here. So let's use the SSID parts on these devices to connect these devices to our access points. For example, tablet. On tablet, let's go wireless part and say home network. Again, for smartphone, let's say home network. As you can see, tablet is connected and smartphone also connected. And I will connect these devices to this access point. So this time, what was our SSID? IP Cisco. Yes, I will change this one. SSID part, again, SSID part, and they are connected one by one, as you can see here. Yes. This is our home network. I will use, again, a colorful schema here. This is our home network, and this is another network, and this time let's use this color. I will use this one. We can also write something here. Home network. Oh, it's IP Cisco network. Home network, or any other think you can take notes here. For example, you can take notes IP addresses, IP addresses of router 0, etc. Anything you can take notes with this part. You can also use this preferences part, and in this part you can check, for example, there are some device models here. There are too much complex writings here. You can remove them, or you can remove the name of the devices, or you can remove both. Maybe this is better, I don't know. Or you can remove the port names, port numbers. And there are also other configurations here. You can also change font, etc. So these are details. So I will not talk about all the things here, but this is basically how we use Packet Tracer and the devices in Packet Tracer. In the following examples, in the following labs, CCNA, CCNP labs, we will use these devices, these configurations too much. So in this basic lesson, I will try to show you how to use devices in Cisco Packet Tracer.